The popularity of gel printing, monoprinting, and gel press plates continues unabated. When new tools come along that allow for more creativity, I'm always all in. The new ones I'm working with today are from Carabelle Studio, their art printing textures. At first glance, they appear to be an unmounted rubber stamp, but as you'll see, they have a very distinct role in gel and monoprinting, and yes, some can be used as a rubber stamp. One of the first things that you'll notice when you take these plates out of the package is that it is just rubber. There's no cling, there's no cushion, there's no nothing on the back. And that's deliberate because of the way that these are intended to be used. But the other thing that you'll notice, and I'm deliberately picking a text stamp here to show you, is that if you try to use this as a regular stamp, now I'm talking this one in particular that has text on it, see how you can read the letters on there? They're not mirror imaged or reversed. That's because they're meant to be put on a print plate, which reverses it, and then when you print on it and pull your print, it reverses it again until it's back to being in an orientation that you can read. If I were to just ink this and stamp it, the letters would be mirror imaged, which may be fine if that's the effect that you're looking for, but that's something that you need to be aware of. These are meant to be used as part of the printing process, and doing that means you're going to get this kind of reverse thing going on. Doesn't mean you can't use them, it just means you need to bear that in mind. So anything with numbers or with text on it will have that effect. Even something like these butterflies, though the main shape is the butterfly, the text on them is set up in such a way that when you pull a print from a plate, it will be oriented correctly so that you can read it. When you talk about things like this, doesn't make a darn bit of difference in the world, and as you'll see, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to work with these like they are a stamp. I'll show you that at the very end. I want you to realize that there's lots of ways to utilize these, and you're not limited to just printing. But since we're here to talk about printing, I'm going to bring in my 8-inch by 10-inch gel press plate. I'm going to throw a couple of colors on here, and then I'm just going to texturize it with the plates. I want you to see how simple it is to use these. So I'm going to start with I'm using Dina Wakely's paint today. I'm going to use a couple of different colors. In fact, let's go for the Gusto, and let's use three different colors and see how this looks. So I don't want too much paint. One of the things that I've learned the more that I work with gel plates or gel printing is that too much paint is not your friend. Now there are certainly some techniques where there's a rhyme and a reason to having a fair amount of paint on there, but if you want a nice crisp print, lots of paint is not the way to get it. So I'm just going to brayer these three colors out here, and I'm actually going to drag this color across. Let's just see how this looks. So I'm rolling the color off to the side on just some scratch paper. So here is this particular thing. Now what I am going to do is I'm going to just grab a scratch piece of paper and I'm going to press the paint that's on here off so that the next time I get a lift, it actually takes plenty off. If I didn't do that, I would be very inclined to get less each time I took that off. So see what happens when you ink it and you stamp it? Your letters are reversed. Once you pull this print, or once I pull this print rather, you'll see that that's going to change. So let's just change this up a little bit and let's turn the characters this way and then go ahead and stamp it off. Now if you had an open journal next to you, it would be an awesome way to go ahead and stamp that stuff off, again, depending on what it is you're doing. So I'm just gonna grab this. I'm actually gonna fill everything in here. Let's just really go for the gusto. Print that off, put a little bit in here. All right, so let me grab a piece of paper, kind of wipe my fingers off. Go ahead and place this on here. Well, I didn't tape my bottom piece down, which I probably should have, but what that does is it allows me to align my paper with what's underneath so I get a reasonably centered image. So how awesome is this? You've got, well, it's upside down, but you've got your letters oriented the right way so that when you read them, they look exactly right, and you can see how easy this process is. I want to say that right now there are 10 different designs. It is as simple as this, but there's of course more that you can do with them. In the last segment, when I used one of the art printing textures to make marks in the paint that was on my gel press plate, you saw me, I stamped it off on another piece of paper. And that's great, you can do that in an open journal, if you've got ATCs in process, whatever it is that you might have that you want to stamp this off on. Or the other option becomes to actually stamp it off on the plate. So this is a background I did several hours ago. It's pretty light, which means I'm not going to have any difficulty getting anything to contrast and show. So I've picked ocean and I think this is fuchsia. I'm only going to put a little bit out here so that when I stamp, I'll be able to stamp the color off here and then I'll go back and print. So I'm going to put a little bit of the fuchsia down. Well, I'm going to This, first of all, this is not fuchsia, this is ocean, but I am going to get some to squeeze out of the bottle. And then we'll come with the fuchsia, and we'll put some down. Again, I don't want to put too much paint down. So I'm going to get this, and there's still some green left from the thing I did a minute ago, which I will show you. I actually made a ghost print. I pulled a ghost print with what was left on the plate after I textured it. So all right, so here's my color. Now I'm going to take this plate, and I'm going to stamp it here and pick up some color, and then I'm going to stamp it off here. Let it run into the previous color there, and then I'm going to do the same thing again, and then we'll print it and see what it looks like. Alright, so what I want to do is come in here and get some texture on here too. See how that works. Kind of fill that in. So here comes the piece that I did a while ago, and rather than print the whole thing, I think I'm just going to grab parts of it. See how that works. So I'm going to print a little bit here. And I'm not going to show you, I want to just come back and print, because obviously we're talking about acrylic paint and there is, you know, not a long open period. So we'll want to take advantage of all of that. And let me grab something else quickly and see if I can just go ahead and print what's in the middle here. Then we'll take a look and see what it looks like. All right, so, whoops. So here's where I lifted. You can see the two colors there, and you can see the impression coming off when I took the paint off the plate. And you can see here what happens when I stamp. So again, here's that kind of going on here. This is what happens when I stamp what is on the surface of the plate back onto the gel press plate. And this is what happens when I lift. So let's try that this time with a... Sorry, words left my brain. Let's try that with a text stamp and see how that looks. Actually, let's use this big text stamp here. That way we can really see what's going to happen. And I think I'm going to repeat the same colors. So we'll just put some of both out here. Go ahead and brayer them on the surface. I didn't actually clean my brayer off the last time, so that's fine too, that I'm reusing the colors. Just kind of get them. All right. I am going to brayer it off this time. So I'm going to come in here, and I'm actually going to stamp like this, and then I'm going to put it down, and I'll just continue to do the same thing along the way here. Oops, well, that's going to leave a little bit of a mark, but that's all right. We'll live with it. And then we'll just grab some that's along here and go ahead and stamp it. Now, what I might try to do is just squeeze a little bit more texture in here. And this time I'm just going to lift. There's really no place left on the plate to stamp it off, but let's see what I can do here. So let me bring this into the side. Let's stamp that off there because we can, and that's pretty awesome. And we'll just pick up a little bit more here and do the same thing and kind of stamp it. So you can see that what happens is you can start to build all these really cool layers. You have all of this stuff going on. And these are tools. These are things that you can use to work with what you have and see where it takes you. So this, let's pick some of this up. Whoops, let's get that out of the way. Let's pick some of this up along the edge here because we can. Again, I've got, if I held it so you could read it, I've got text on here, which is awesome, that I really like. This is something that I'm going to show you in a minute. This is kind of left over from something else, and I've got a lot of space on here. So let's come in and print this. So now, let me look at this myself. So now when I look at this, the letters are still facing in the right direction because I've stamped it one way, and then it reverses when I print, so I can go ahead and read that. And then I'm just going to grab what's in the middle here. So, you know, one of the things that I tend to do the most, again, here, how awesome is that? I've got this kind of filigree thing going on just on top of the letters, which I really like. So one of the things that you often see me and a lot of other people do when we're working with a gel press plate is to bring in a stencil. So that's going to be the last thing I show you. I want to show you how you can work with a stencil and start making, you can use these plates to start texturing the areas, the opening areas, open areas in a stencil. For this technique to be effective, one of the things that you need to keep in mind is the size of the elements on the texture plate versus the size in the openings in your stencil. So this is a pretty dense design, and I'm going to have, if I kind of put something under this so you're not looking at what's underneath. I have some reasonably good size open areas. I can make this work. I'm going to show you that second. What I also want to show you is when you have a stencil with wide open, like this is our sunflower stencils, when you have a stencil that's got wide open areas like that, you can take advantage of some of these larger patterns. So again, we'll come in here and we'll just put some color on here. And actually, hopefully at the end I'll remember. I won't wander off and forget I wanted to do this. I want to show you the pickup prints I used, or I pulled, by just grabbing what was on the plate to clean it up. If I'm lucky, I'll remember. So I'm going to get some color going here. That's probably not quite enough of the ocean. I could squeeze a little bit more out there. One of the interesting things when you use these squeezy bottles from Dina Wakely is sometimes you get pattern from the way you squeeze the paint out on the plate. In fact, you can see that here. And so I am going to interrupt my thought process for a second. This is one of the pickup prints. This is what I did with what was left on the plate after the last segment. You can see that I squirted the paint on in a circular pattern and it never brayered out all the way. So it's pretty cool the way that that works. I'm going to lay the sunflower stencil on my brayered out paint. Now it's getting a little dry over here, so we'll have to see how that goes. And I'm going to grab this of the texture plates. And I'm just going to start pressing. Now, I can even press through these smaller openings in the stencil and someplace here. You know what? Let's just print it off on here and see what happens. I'm going to pick up the color, and I'll show you this at the end once I get through picking all this stuff up or putting this texture on, however you want to describe it. What I think is cool is I can even, maybe not on this little tiny sunflower, but I can even get the texture to happen through the petals in the sunflower. So I think that that's pretty interesting. And that, I don't know how that's going to, and actually I think I put color down there. So this is what happens when I stamped it off, which is cool. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to print this. What I should have done, and what I'll do the next time, is pick some of the paint up through the openings in the stencil and then print, but we'll see what happens. So I'm going to kind of press this down and we'll see what this looks like, because I want to get the stencil in contact with the paint that's on the surface of the plate. This is kind of not my normal way of working. I was talking too much. So we'll pick this up. Oh, that is going to work. I like that. Who knew? All right, so let's go ahead and print this and see what it looks like. Oh, see, that's pretty awesome. So you get the texture that happens in here. You get the color pattern that happened because I put that kind of gradient out. And you get the back of the stencil creating patterning in the paint that was left on there. So that's pretty cool. All right, so next thing, I'm going to reuse the same colors so I'm not fighting anything on here. I don't want to make mud. So I'll just come back with some more color. Let's get some of this out here. I'm going a little bit heavier this time, and there is a reason for that, besides the fact that I might have lost my mind. I want to get a little bit more paint down here, because ordinarily when I use a stencil, what I'm going to do is lay it down. I'm going to take a piece of scratch paper and pick up paint through the openings in the stencil, and then I'm going to print. With the intermediary step this time, that once I pick the color up through the openings in the stencil, and let's find, what did I do with that stencil? Let's find that stencil and that other texture plate. What'll happen is there's going to be less paint there. So all right, so here we go. I'm going to lay the stencil down. I'm going to grab a piece of scratch paper, and I'm going to pick up color through the openings in the stencil. So every place the paint touches the paper, it's going to adhere, and there'll be less of it left there. Now, it didn't press hard enough in every place, but I can certainly remedy that by coming back and doing this. Now I'm going to take my plate, and I'm going to start randomly applying texture through here and see what happens. And I'm not stamping off, so I might find that I'm getting color transferring. You never know when you play like this. Sometimes you have great things happen that you certainly never expected. Whoops. All right, so that looks pretty good. What I'm going to do now is lift this up, grab another piece of paper, and print, and we'll see what she looks like. Oh, see how awesome is that? You get all this fabulous color. This is one of my favorite stencils in our line. This is one Margaret Applin designed that's called Endless. You get all this patterning, you get all this color, and then you get the background that happens because of what happened with the art printing texture plate. So one other thing, this is kind of this deconstructed grungy look that I'm finding myself attracted to some of the time. Let's try pulling a ghost print and see what happens. That's the pickup print I did with what was left on the plate after the first segment that I filmed. That's pretty cool too. So there's different layers and different interesting things going on in there. The green is there because I use that as the color to do the pickup print. So you know, whether you're working with them, like I just showed you, or you find another way to take advantage of all that these are, I think you're going to find that you like the Carabelle Studio art printing textures.